Right, today is the anniversary of David Bowie's death. 10th of January 2016. Today, year on, 2017, I'm going on a similar walk I did when I first discovered on that day, where it could have been going into the 11th actually. It's a possibility it went into the 11th because of the different times. But anyway, I'm doing it on this day now, the 10th, the proper day of his death. It was a better, brighter day, blue sky, pink skies actually, with beautiful puffy clouds. Lots of lovely shapes. And the shapes of those clouds took on images of David Bowie for me. But today the skies are grey. Almost a reflection of what he said was a disappointing 21st century so far. This morning when I got up, I put the television on. I often do to see the news, and the Victoria Derbyshire programme was on. And then she started to interview George Underwood live on TV on his reflections and everything, and it was a very moving tribute to David Bowie by George, a lifelong friend since he was 9 years old of David Bowie, often a companion in the early days, and an artist to some of the covers, an artist in his own right with super artwork. But as the interview progressed, it must have lasted a good quarter of an hour, 20 minutes, I would have thought. It might not have lasted that long, I don't know. George started to tremble, and he started to get visibly very upset and cry almost. He was holding back, trying not to. I think the interview might have been cut short because of it. But anyway, it was a lovely remembrance of David Bowie by a man who knew him well from childhood, who explained how lively David was, how full of enthusiasm for whatever he did, and funny, hilarious, he described him. So, with that knowledge, it reinforces what a lot of us know or have learned about him. Today is special. I never knew a year on, I never knew a year ago that I would feel so intense. I never realised how I share this collective passion for him and how real the grief is. It still seems unreal, because for me, David had always been there from my very early years, and I liked folk music. I used to play guitar. I was an electric folk band once. I loved music like a lot of us did and do. And he was always there. I took him for granted. He was like an institution almost. You can't have pop music or anything like it unless David Bowie's about. Everything comes from that sort of thing. He pioneered so much. And so, but after he had his heart attacks, obviously he rested. Understandable. He had a young daughter. He also always said, once you get to 57, which is when he had the heart attack, you still feel on top of your world, you know, but you are starting to get fragile, really. And so he disappeared almost for a while, you know. For a while, quite a while, actually. It was about 7 years at least. Just trying to count from... Yeah, it was about 7 years. And then he came back with his beautiful exhibition in London, which I went to see at the Q&A. And V&A, I mean, Victoria and Albert. And plus, he brought out a record, didn't he? Where Are We Now? And some other bits and pieces. So, you know, I wasn't overrun with it, but I still loved his exhibition. I stayed there for hours and hours. I thought, what a good idea to keep all this stuff. Quite disappointed last year when his artwork was being sold. Whether he sold it for charity or something, I don't know. That was a bit of a disappointment, but someone will be caring for it. Someone will be the new custodian of David's work in that way. There's always a reason for it. Because if he didn't want it sold, he would have made it very clear, I think. He was that sort of person. No one would have been able to have done that, touched it. But of course, insuring artwork like that must have cost a fortune. You know, so we'll never really know. But someone will, a man will know, and his son, Duncan. And that's the other thing. Of course, little Stenton was born as well. Hold on, somebody could come in. I'll just hold on a minute. So I'm you going back, are you? Hello. So I'm friendly. I'm just videoing this bit. Oh, hello. I am friendly. Go on, go on. Off you go. That's it. Sorry, I don't want to turn my video off because I'll have to edit this bit out. Because I'm doing a video about David Bowie at the moment. Okay, thank you. No, all right, love. So where was I? Oh, yeah. So basically, Stenton arrives in 2016, summer. And, what can I say? David knew that Stenton was going to be born. He knew he was a boy. He knew at Christmas. So that, in a way, he must have felt very, very happy about that. Indeed. Very happy for his son. And hopefully his legacy will pass on. Of course, Lexi as well, who will also probably become a mum one day. I got lost a bit there because somebody with four boxers just shot up on me for a while. I don't know whether I'll have that in this video. I might edit that bit out. But I'm in the wood. I'm walking. It's always a risk I'm going to bump into somebody. And I'm up here to reflect over the past year and all the feelings. And I was saying how I took him for granted, really. He was always there. He was young, really, dying in this day and age. It just shows that money doesn't save you. I mean, he must have been able to afford the best treatment, but I've got my own views about what happened to him with his treatment. We all know, well, some of us know that this chemo stuff sometimes is worse for you. And of course, in his case, it was too late to do a transplant, I believe. Anyway, we can't speculate or make judgments about his health like that, really. He left a huge legacy. I mean, to me, he is very big in the world. Is following everything. His spiritualness. And his love that he did, create around us all. He generated this. He was also like a leader in many ways. And a lot of us feel lost without him. He was never a puppet, a pop puppet. If he was, it was for a very short time, and he realized that he was being taken for a ride. In some of his interviews, he mentions the importance of doing what you want, not to be told what to do by others exactly. It's not always easy to do that, mind, because you have to fall in line with legalities and stuff, and sometimes you have to sort of follow some sort of rules. Right, so this is the end of part. This is the end of part one. I'm going to take some photos now and then come back when I get near the Iron Age Fort, which is where I'm heading. To the Iron Age Fort, where I go and do a lot of reflecting. I actually go lots of other places as well, Cheddar Gorge area, Glastonbury, of course, which I love very, very much. But I'll close this one for now, as people might get bored with it, be too long, but I'm doing it for posterity. I'm doing it as a record. I've got my other videos that I've done and kept, and I've got an archive for David Bowie. I'm doing his family tree. I do my own family tree. So basically, this will be kept along with all the other articles, information, extracts, images that I'm building up, as a lot of other people are. We're not alone when we're doing this. We are sharing it all. I share what I can. That's the good thing about Facebook. Keep out with certain things, like don't get into family squabbles if you can help it. Because you don't want the world to know all your business. But it's very good for the groups that you can join and participate in. And realise this collective feeling. Over and out. This is Sheila, the 10th of January 2017, remembering David Bowie.